If you're migrating to Google Analytics 4, or GA4, from Universal Analytics, or GA3, I've got something that might be very helpful. It'll be helpful if you're running GA3 through Google Tag Manager, or GTM, and if you have a lot of GA3 events that you want to migrate. This tool, the GA4 Migration Tool from Ben Kuehn, who's a software engineer at Google, is really helpful, particularly if you're an agency or, again, have a large number of GA3 events. Now, it doesn't take out the thinking you have to do, which events you want to migrate and what you want to call them, but it makes the process much easier. Hi, I'm Fred Pike. I'm a managing director at Northwoods, and I'm the GA GTM practice lead here. Today, we're going to talk about the what, when, and why of the Ben Kuehn GA4 migration tool. We'll talk about some prerequisites that you should have set up before you start the process, and then we'll spend most of our time setting up and running the GA4 migration tool itself. I'll also show you some possible errors so you won't be confused if you run into them. So what is the Ben Kuehn GA4 migration tool? It's really a structured way to replicate GA3 events. It's going to give you a new GA4 event using the same trigger as the GA3 event. And note, this is for migration, not for creating new events. You can't create new events in here. It only touches the GTM container. It doesn't affect your GA3 or GA4 properties at all. And thus, it requires that you're using Google Tag Manager, of course. So when might you use this? A couple of instances. First, your GTM container has 10 plus GA3 events. If you only have 3 or 4 GA3 events, don't worry about them. You can migrate those on your own. If you have 80 or 100, this is a great tool to use. You might also use this if you're an agency and you have a lot of GA3 accounts that you're going to migrate to GA4. So why would you use this? First, it gives you a really nice layout of all the GA3 events. All in one place, you can see how they're set up. You can see the event category, action, and label, everything that all the values that are being used there. So it's a really nice layout. It helps you work your way through the migration. You don't have to do everything at once. You can do this in phases. You can migrate 3 or 4 events and then publish a container and then migrate some more. So it's a nice way to stage the migration process. It also lets you document your process and your thinking of what you went through to do the migration. So let's start with the prerequisites. First, you are going to want to have a GA4 property created. You're going to want to have the GA4 configuration tag already created in GTM.
While the tool can create a config tag for you, I think it's easier to just set it up yourself in GTM.
You'll want a GA4 migration workspace in GTM, and I'll show you this in just a little bit. But what this migration tool won't do is create a plan for what events to move and what to name them when you move them to GA4. So this doesn't take all the mystery out of the migration. You still have to think about what you want to migrate and what you want to call it. That's really a key part of the GA4 migration. And I'll tell you, you do not want to recreate the GA3 event category, action, and label. You don't want to move those over to GA4 just like that, because the GA4 event model is very different than the GA3 model, and you really want to have a rich event name and very descriptive parameters around that event name. So let's get started with setting up the tool. We are going to use the website of the Milwaukee Mandolin Orchestra for our GA4 migration example. It has an existing Google Tag Manager account with a relatively small number of GA3 events. And notice that it already has the GA4 configuration tag set up. I've used a variable for the GA4 measurement ID, and I also have 3 field names that I use on all the GTM containers I set up. I won't go into that here, but if you wanted to copy this structure, that would be great. So how do you get the Ben Kuehn GA4 Migration Tool? The best way to get that is to go to github.com and just search on GA4 Migration. Up comes the GA4 GTM Migration Tool, and you can download it from here. I already have it downloaded. I will typically make a copy of the blank version and keep the blank version available for future use. Once you've made the copy, you'll want to wait for the new menu item to appear up here. And now it has appeared. So from this point, you're ready to begin the process. The first thing you'll want to do is actually authorize it.
That will let the tool read from and write to the GTM container.
So we'll start with authorize permissions. Go ahead and ignore that and go right to the tool. From this point, once it's authorized, we can start and go to the new menu. We're going to work our way down through this GTM workspace selection and then to the event migration. So we'll start here. We'll list the GTM accounts that this Google account has access to. Choose the one you want. Define the containers. Select the container. And here's where, before we move on, we want to go back to our Google Tag Manager container and add a new workspace. The reason you want a new workspace is that all your changes will happen here and they're not going to affect work that anybody else is doing in the GTM container. It's a nice way to always organize your work. So now let's choose our workspaces. And we're going to choose the GA4 migration workspace we just created. We're ready to move to the next item in the menu. Again, we're not going to do anything with the page view. This primarily sets up the GA4 config tag, which we've already set up. So we're going to start right with event migration and set our UA settings variables. And we are also going to move to the event migration tab. This is our GA setting from GTM. We're going to use that. Go on to the next event. And now we will see all the GA3 events show up here. As I mentioned, it's a fairly small list of events in this GTM container, and some we don't have to move. YouTube videos, outbound link clicks, and file downloads are all part of the enhanced measurement in GA4, so we don't have to move those GA3 events. So there's really only two events that we are going to migrate, and normally I wouldn't bother with this migration tool, but I want to show you what you can do. And then this transfers very easily to GTM containers that have a much larger number of events. The first thing I normally do is copy the GA3 event names to the GA4 event tag name and change their names through a find and replace. I now have GA4 tag names. I don't know what the event name is going to be yet, but I know that I want to use the GA4 config tag that I had already created. Now I could just type that in. I know what the name of that is, GA4 configuration. But I can also call it in, and this might be useful later. So let's do this, optional GTM variables. Now that configuration tag shows up. So I'm going to use that configuration tag. And I'm only going to migrate two tags. So this one and this one. And notice that the color comes up, letting me know that there's something missing there. So here's where you do have to do some planning and thinking about what are you going to call the event name. Now, form submitted, for example, there is no corresponding event name in Google Analytics. If we look at the list of events, either the enhanced measurement or recommended events, none of those truly reflect a form submitted. The closest one might be the recommended event of generate lead, But if we take a look at the parameters around the generate lead, they're really not that useful. Currency and value, that doesn't help me in many cases on a form submission because I probably want to know the form name, possibly the form ID, possibly the page that the person was on. So rather than use a recommended event, I'm probably going to create my own event name here. And notice that it's snake case, all lowercase, with spaces being an underscore. So the fact that it's green means I have everything set over here. And for this, a social media follow, I may not know what that is yet. So let's actually call those events up and see what they are. Back to our migration tool, list the UA event data. So we're now populating the third set of columns over here. And the social media follow, as I look at it here, is telling us what icon they clicked on, basically. So let's use the event name of social media. I'm not sure I would actually migrate this, but for the purposes of this example, let's do that. Now we're going to actually create the GA4 event. And if we wanted to, we could actually use the exact same actions that they have here, the category, action, and label, but we don't want to do that. And what I've been doing is just creating some space down here. I'm going to copy the event, and now I have to give it a user property or parameter name. So we know in this case, we know that the event name is form submitted, and notice that we were using the form name and the form ID in GA3. That's a packed cell. We have more than one item of information in that cell. So I want to break that out. So let's call this the parameter name. Let's call it form name. We're going to use the DLV form name. And let's call it form ID. These show up, by the way, because we ran this GTM variables option. That's how, when I start typing DLV, that's how it showed up. If you can, it's great to use an existing parameter, again, from over here. And there may not be parameters that you can use really easily, so you might have to create your own. But if you can, try to use an existing parameter. In this case, we really don't have an existing parameter that corresponds. So we are going to convert this to a parameter, and we're going to migrate it for this tag only, the corresponding one. Same thing here. And now these are going to be ready to migrate. Let's do the same thing with the social media ones down here. We know that our event name is social media. This time, let's use a special generic tag name that I've been using of type. Let's say that this one is follow. And I also have a generic that I've been using subtype, and that's going to be the regex of the social media follow. And one thing I've been adding on all my tags is the actual tag name, which I think is really helpful. So let's do that up here. We are now set, almost set. We have two tags that we've migrated, we've chosen to migrate. We've now set up what the parameters are going to be. So over here is the event name. Over here are the parameters for each of those events. So we are just about ready to migrate. There is one more set of GA3 data I may want to move over. And that's the custom definitions. If you're using custom dimensions in GA3 and you want to use them in GA4, you can add them here. And the one that I really want is this hit timestamp. I'm not going to go into what that is, but let's just say that I'm going to use that. I'm going to convert that to a parameter. And this time, I'm going to apply it to all event tags. Over here, we were doing corresponding. This time, I'm going to apply it to all event tags. So this new parameter of hit timestamp is going to be added to every single event as a new parameter. So we are ready to migrate. We are done. Let's take a look at our GTM container. Let's look at our overview. And look, there are the two tags we just created, the GA4 form submitted and the social media follow. Let's look at one of them, the event name of form submitted. Those are the parameter names that we added, form name, form ID, tag name, as well as the hit timestamp. So it has moved over. That's pretty cool. Now let's look at a couple of errors that might come up. What happens if we accidentally migrate these again? We finish the migration, we go over to GTM, refresh, and you see we now have four tags rather than the two tags we should have, and the duplicate tags have an extension of GA4. So if we did it one more time, we now have GA4, GA4. So basically, we don't want those. We're going to just get rid of them. And now we're back to ones that we can publish. Another error I often run into is if I decide to publish this one, and then later I'm in here and I've made some more changes and I'm going to migrate my new changes, you'll get a rather cryptic message. And what's happening is that that workspace is now gone. If we look at the GTM container, we only have the default workspace now, because that GA4 workspace has now been published. But in our spreadsheet, we're still trying to use it. So what you'd want to do in this case is start again and list the workspaces. And now we're only going to have the default one. So we don't want to use the default one. We want to create another GA4 migration, but that's the type of error that'll come up. One of the huge advantages of the tool is that it does provide documentation. Here's an example of a filled-in spreadsheet I've done. I use color-coded to let me know if some of the events had moved. I'm specifying events that don't move. I'm specifying some that are no longer appropriate, so I didn't migrate them. I have information about some of the new events that I added or what I had to do to get them to work in GA4. Here's another example where some events had not occurred since 2018, so I didn't move them. So this whole process of doing the GA4 migration is a great time to look at the GTM container and make sure that the events that you have in there still makes sense for the website. The website might have changed. Those events may not be firing anymore. Document the ones that you've deleted, that you've decided not to migrate, and then you'll always have this spreadsheet as your tool to know what you did as part of the GA4 migration. The time you spend now in documenting what you did is going to really save you 6 months from now when you're trying to figure out, what the heck did I do? I hope this was useful. I do want to make sure that you know to follow Ben Kuehn. He's on Twitter. He does request that you put any comments about his tools, like the GA4 migration tool or some other great ones he's got, that you do that in the GitHub groups. And you know that he's a great guy because he's got a picture of his dog. So he's a winner in my book by definition. Make sure to follow me also on Twitter or LinkedIn. I'm much more active on Twitter because Ben is showing his dog. I will show my dog, Xuxa, also. Hope this was useful.